Hey, hey, welcome back to the Conversion Clinic. In this video, I'm going to show you how to optimize your images for SEO in three simple steps. So, step one is using a free tool called Figma. So Figma is a design tool, anyone can use it, super easy. When you go and sign up to Figma, log in, create a new design file, and then you'll see something like this. So what you want to do, and the reason why you watch this video is because you've got an image that's probably too big, right? Like this one here, it's 117 kilobytes. Recommend is over under 100 kilobytes for SEO purposes. So what we might do, I'm using Screaming Frog. You might use any other tool or even a speed test tool to find this out. Basically, you wanna go find the image that's too big. So I've opened this image and I might wanna save it to my computer or copy the image itself. Then I'm gonna go over to Figma and I might decide that I wanna resize it. Maybe I've got a blog post and it has to fit into this area, but it doesn't need to be this bloody big for that purpose. Okay, so I might wanna shrink it. That's totally up to you what you do, or you can skip this step to step two, which is just compressing the image itself. Right? So you might want to just save this to your computer and you might want to go to the tinypng.com and we're going to compress it. Okay. So it's really, really easy. So you might want to just compress it or you might want to convert it to a WebP file, which I highly recommend if you're using new WordPress, use a WebP file because it's for modern browsers. And then what you want to do is open that up. You can see that this has converted from 117 kilobytes or 120, it's saying, down to 32. So that's already a massive saving. Okay, so you can, depending on how big your image is and you compress it, you should be able to see the same thing in Figma. All you need to do is like shrink it, for example. You go to export PNG. So you've exported as a PNG, do the same process. You then open that up, 494 kilobytes. But it's gone down to 19 kilobytes. So it's even smaller than the other one, despite it saying it's the PNG was much higher, okay? So that's a quick win as well. So let's move on to step three. Step three, the final step, is to add alt tags or alt image text to the actual images itself. Now, I've got another tutorial for this. I've got the free template there, which is what you're seeing on the screen there. Go watch it, it'll tell you the rest, but that's pretty much everything. That's the three-step process on how to optimize images for SEO. If you found this helpful, leave a comment below, ask away. I'll respond to it within 48 hours or something like that, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.